Say you've built an agentic AI system, but you're looking to boost its performance and reliability. Today, we'll explore how model fine-tuning can be your next step in supercharging your AI agent's capabilities. In this video, we'll explore key considerations for customizing your models within your agentic system of different levels of autonomy. We will discuss the shortcomings of current system designs and how we can systematically address these challenges through fine-tuning. And most importantly, we will focus on practical design tips for data collection that can enable effective fine-tuning. Keep in mind that this is a continuously evolving field with a changing terminology. First, why agentic systems? Agentic systems are purpose-built to address complex, multi-step problems that require degrees of autonomy and creativity. This allows the systems to adapt and make context-aware decision-making. What grounds this approach is the use of the toolkit. The unique blend of large language models generalization capabilities with the domain alignment of the toolkit allows agentic systems to tackle the problems where traditional automation falls short. However, this flexibility comes with a trade-off. Without the deep domain-specific knowledge, your large language model might fail to use the tools correctly. Furthermore, it might make decisions that are not aligned with your organization's unique objectives and constraints. This calls for the deeper integration between the large language model and the toolkit. So what are the key limitations of the current designs? First one is high token inefficiency. Instead of using tokens to solve your problem, you use token-heavy prompt that agents require just for the setup, limiting the number of tokens the agent can use for execution, actually making the decision and trying to solve your problem. Furthermore, it draws the focus away from the problem that you're trying to solve. Second one is the high cost of the execution. Every time you're running your agent, you're embedding the same amount of token, which has a computational overhead and results in higher cost. And the most important problem that with agentic systems, since they are working with the multi-step complex problems, there is an issue of error propagation. So if the agent makes incorrect decision in the beginning of the execution trace, all the following decisions might not lead to the correct answer, which can lead to the agent's fail rate go up and agents stuck in the feedback loops and not achieving the task successfully. So over time, you're running into the higher cost just because your model has a shallow understanding that doesn't allow it to make more effective domain-aligned decisions. If fine-tuning can address these challenges, how should we approach data collection? Well, let's split this conversation into two parts. One, we're gonna talk about the tool-specific data, and another one is going to be general reasoning, decision-making, or planning capabilities. So for the tool collection, the most important thing to explain to the model is when to use the tool, how to call it, and what to do with the output. So for the first part, you're trying to explain the context. Let's say you have two very similar tools for search, but they have different context where they should be applied. Focus on creating the examples that highlight these differences. Annotate it with explanations and try to provide the model with as much information as possible. How to use the tool is the opportunity to teach the model how to properly configure the call parameters to the tool. Where should this reasoning come from? and how to use the tool effectively to achieve the specific task that the model is trying to solve. And what to do with the output is defining the expectations for the model. For example, is the tool that you're trying to use deterministic? Can you trust the output? Do you have to do any of the post-processing when you get the output from the tool? One thing that I would like to focus on is right tools specifically. Right tools are the tools that modify your environment. So make sure to be extra careful when you provide the guidelines for those tools. As a general approach, we reserve to fine-tune it here because we want to show the full range of capabilities. So focus on the edge cases and make sure to provide annotations to your model so it can reason better about each of the tool use steps. This is especially important if you are building your agentic workflow using custom tools that model might not reason well about by default. Building on the principles that we use for data collection for more effective tool use, we can talk about how we can enhance models' reasoning, planning, and decision-making capabilities. First, we should treat this as an opportunity to get the model aligned with your organization-specific policies and objectives. You can do that through the use of documentation. If you structure and use that as training data, this will give the model a great background to rely on when making the decisions. Furthermore, you can use case studies and showcase how the decisions are made within the organizations, which policies in which scenarios are being consulted, so the model has this understanding when it is trying to make decisions on its own. And most importantly, since your agent is already running, you can collect, analyze the execution traces. Then you can help the model with annotating successful and unsuccessful decisions, explaining why in the certain scenarios it is more beneficial to proceed one route over the other one. Additionally, if your system has any role-specific components, for example, you have judges, validators, or optimizers, you can collect role-specific data and improve the robustness of your system by highlighting how these decisions should be made when these decisions are made within the context of the specific role. As with any AI system, agentic systems thrive on iterative improvement. By collecting, analyzing, and inspecting your execution data, you can find the failure modes of your AI system. These lessons can be incorporated either into your prompting techniques, but also these failure modes could be a great source for fine-tuning data. As with all the fine-tuning data that you're going to collect, whether it's going to be regarding the tool use or the general decision-making capabilities of the model, make sure to provide very detailed annotations. You can use React or other structured reasoning frameworks to help model process these annotations and become more effective, robust, and reliable. Remember, the ultimate goal of fine-tuning is creating a system that is more aligned with your unique challenge. It comes with additional benefits as reducing cost and making the system more efficient. But most importantly, it transforms your agentic system from a novel solution to a trusted and reliable partner. Applying techniques that we discussed today for data collection can hopefully help you customize your agentic workflow better.